with us next speaker, and she's working as assistant professor of geology and presently posted at Dakshin Kamrup College, Mirza Kamrup, Assam, India. She is MPhil in zoology and presently pursuing her PhD from Assam Don Vasuko University, Tapasya, Assam, India. The topic of her presentation is streams and fish diversity of South Kamrup district of Assam. Mrs. Chaudhary, you have 12 to 15 minutes for your presentation, please. The floor is yours. You're most welcome, ma'am.
Good afternoon, sir. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
I think my video is coming. So, good afternoon, because in Indian time, it is good afternoon. And respected chairperson, sir, and respected co-chairperson, sir, and the expert faculty members. And let me introduce myself. I'm Elora Chaudhary, and sir has already, introduced myself. And basically, I'm a scholar, PhD scholar, and my area is ornamental fish diversity.
Dr. Chaudhary, can you raise your camera to bit the height so that we can see you?
Yes.
Now it's fine. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Can I share my screen, sir?
Yeah, please.
Sir, is it visible?
Yeah, it's visible. Please go ahead.
So, in today's...
Excuse me, you please just increase the full screen. You see the, this?
Yeah,
I can hear. Yeah.
Yes, right. Click it.
Click this.
Click.
Is it visible,
yes.
Sir?
Yes.
Yes, thank you. So today's topic is streams and fish diversity of South Kamrup districts of Assam in India. So as we know that India is well known for its biodiversity, specifically in freshwater fish diversity and marine fish diversity. And Assam is a state of India, which is not in the northeastern part of India. And I am going to present my research paper on the streams and fish diversity of South Kamrup district of Assam. Basically, streams are water bodies of all sizes, having channels of running water, which have fluvial processes. Channel composes components such as pools, riffles, steps, cascades, and all plant beds provide important habitat for many organisms like fishes and many aquatic organisms. So in case of Assam, there is many hill streams are there, basically in the South Kamrup part of Assam, which is southern in the southern valley of Brahmaputra River. So many works have been done in this regard, but specifically in the wetlands, in the rivers, or in many aquatic habitats, but very less literatures are found in the streams and fish diversity of this, that means in these hill streams. So I have focused on this in particularly in this aspect. So the hill streams are basically in the southern part, it is hilly terrain and it shares the interstate borders with Meghalaya. And these hilly terrains are very important biogeographic zones and contains a numbers of stream, creeks and waterfalls, pools. And these habitats basically, these are crucial for fish species abundance. So in the upper reaches, basically, the diversity is very less, but in the lower reaches, where it intermingles with the rivers, there diversity is more. So I'm moving for the next slide. So as we know that Assam is the northeastern, is one of the northeastern Indian states. So it forms a part of two of the 36 biodiversity hotspots. So the Himalayan and the Indo-Burma hotspots. So biodiversity hotspots. So as we are getting two biodiversity hotspots, so species richness is much more and endemicity is of species is also much more. So Assam is also it is getting conjugation of two biodiversity hotspots, that is Himalayas as well as Indomarma. Indomarma is basically under some of the northeastern states are also getting. So many of the freshwater species, some scientists have, that means ichthyologists, they have surveyed and they have got information that is 42 species of freshwater fish diversity, out of which in the northeastern states, 311 species are reported from the Assam, reported from Assam. So Assam is rich in freshwater fish diversity, and many studies have been taken in different aspects of, that means different diverse aquatic habitats. But specifically, I have told that in hill streams, there is very scanty of literatures are available. So as a review of literature, I have searched that Islam et al. Have reported a total of 57 species of fish from the Kulsi River. So actually, this river is actually, it carrying the stream, that means stream waters also, and it is in the lower reaches. So it is intermingling with the Brahmaputra River. And in the wetlands, many wetlands are there. Sanubi Lake is another important wetland. There is Deeperville is there, another Ramsar site, which is also having freshwater fish diversity. And literatures in this regard, specifically in the many species have reported from these regions, but literature is in this, that means in the streams are, however, is very less. So that is why I have selected three streams in the South Kamrup district of Assam, specifically which is the interstate border with Meghalaya. And these streams, they are emerging from the Meghalaya. So I have chosen the study area, which is conducted in the southern part of the Kamrup district, which shares the interstate border. And basically the hill is West Khasi Hill. Meghalaya Hills, Meghalaya is known for its, that means many hills are there, Garo Hills and West Khasi Hill, East Garo Hills are there. But this Kamrup district of Assam is adjoining with the Meghalaya through this West Khasi Hill. And so that is why, this, as it is an interstate border, it is having these streams and which is originating from the Meghalaya. And so this Rani Khama, Salukadare, and Rani Kapili, these three streams are located in this, that means Meghalaya interstate border. And basically I have shown in the map also. So here, this is the India and this is the Assam map. And you will find this Kamrup region. This is the Meghalaya. Here, this interstate border is there. And here, this is the place basically where I have carried out my survey, or you can say study here. So this is the place actually from which we have selected the streams. They are very, you can say very, inaccessible terrains because of the which people often, actually people visit as an ecotourism spot, some of the streams, but many of them are already not, that means their fish survey is not done. So I have selected in such an area where the that means the works are really less. So we, from this study, we have gone, we have some materials and method I have chosen, and the survey is, though it is conducted for a very short brief period, but samples were collected and it is preserved in formaldehyde solution and were identified according to the identification books by which the keys were, diagnostic features and keys were there. And so after surveying those spots, that we have found a total species of fishes belonging to 41 genera, 23 families and 8 orders. They were recorded from the study. And from the study period, we have observed many, that means the behaviors of the fishes also, and basic field data were collected also. And from this, that means study, we have found that many of the fishes, which is belonging to the Cypriniformis family, and it is dominating. Many of the fishes, because the study was, it was done in the lower reaches of the river, lower reaches of the streams, and the upper reaches of the streams, basically it is very highly inaccessible due to the very elevation, because of the elevations. So we have found that fish diversity is dominated by the Cypriniformis, followed by Perciformis and Silviformis. Then some of the fishes like loaches, which is inside the Siphoniformes obviously, but they are belonging to the family Cobitidae and Bellitoridae. They are found in the bottom of the stream bed, having actually hill stream fishes, and they have unique typical body. They are very small in size, except some of the we say carps, major carps. So catfishes are very predominant in the habitat of the streams, which are having sand and gravel and muddy bottom. And from the study, it was seen that basically they like to prefer, you can say, catfishes. They are very predominant in these streams below the sand, suppose beside the gravels and in the muddy bottom. We can find in these areas. And those sucker fishes, which is remaining, that means they remain entangled with the fish, that is cobbles, usually the small, that is rocks, and usually they prefer the cobbles and small pebbles in the pools of the stream. And from the study, it was also seen that the fishes, they are abundant actually, they are more at the confluent site. Because I have already studied as well as surveyed also, that their abundance of the fishes are more in the confluent zone. Confluent zones mean the place where the streams are coming and in the lower reaches, and they're intermingling with the river side. So many of the hill stream fishes, they have also ornamental value. And basically these fishes, they have some adaptive features, adaptive modification in their body. And they have suckers. Some of them have suckers in their modification. Their pelvic fins are modified. So they have many adaptations for being in the, that is hill stream, because the temperature is also a guiding factor. And another is dissolved oxygen. In hill streams, dissolved oxygen is far more compared to the other aquatic habitats because of the, torrentiality of the water conditions. And by this way, the hill stream fishes offers a very good services to the ecological services to the, or you can say they can be used as the different majors. They can be used as the bioindicators also. So they are very good indicators of the stream habitat. So their assemblies can be useful. Their assemblies can be useful in monitoring the stream ecosystem, their water quality, and different, suppose, the chemical factors. And basically, their assemblies also helps in monitoring the food quality, or you can say the food availability. Because of the availability of the food, whenever available food will be there, the fishes will be there. So assemblies pattern can be monitored. Now, the stream fishes, actually, though we are saying that less literatures are available, so study must be carried on these sites, because as we know, the hills are inhabited by many, I can say, local ethnic communities. In search of food, they are also searching these hills as their resource. So many of the hill stream fishes, their species, that means their population is getting, you can say, very density is also that means lower, their populations are lower because of the some anthropogenic disturbances, actually. There are such as sand and boulder mining, sometimes deforestations, many causes are there. And they actually, these causes disturb the stability of and the physical environment of the streams. As well as, we have seen that some indiscriminate type of fishing also occurs, or illegal kind of fishing also occurs, by which actually poisoning the pools, by poisoning the streams also, they caught fishes. So because of this, because this kind of anthropogenic disturbances may cause the viability of this species in the stream habitat. So therefore, actually, the studies must be taken in this regard, because the streams and riparian zones, which is by the side of the streams, these zones must be having vegetation covers, and this must be studied. And because of its systematic investigation only, we can know the intricacies in the lotic ecology, about the lotic ecology, as well as you know that the relationship of riparian zones along with the hill stream fishes are more because of the autochthonous and allochthonous kind of, that is, nutrient assemblies. And by this way, we can see that this is the list of fishes where you can see the cypriniform is having the fishes like Labio species, Sahina species, and it is having, that is Capdio morar, but likewise many Puntia species are also available, Salmostoma becaila, Salmofacia pulo, and Botia dario, which is a very colorful ornamental fish, which is also having good ornamental value. They can be used as the ornamental fishes. And many of the hill streams are often used as the ornamental species. Then many of the, you can say the, then many, the list is, the rest part of the list is this. This is many orders are there. Perciformes, Belloniformes, Tetraodontiformes, Cyprinodontiformes, Osteoglossiformes. So this is a table of the fish faunal diversity, which is found in the study media. So some of them are very, that is kind of Silurhynchus species, is a hill stream fish. So many of the fishes which is found in this area. So I have calculated the number and inserted in a pie diagram. So I have found that most of the family, among this family, the Cyprinidae is having, that is under the Cypriniformes order, Cyprinidae family having 22 family is there. And out of which is the highest dominant family, after which the Siluriformes, that is the order is there after Cypriniformes. And this, after that only other related, other, that is orders are there. So it is a depiction which is family wise distribution of the species. And we can, I can show some of the glimpses of the study area. It is truly hill stream where the water temperature is very optimum, at the optimum level. Definitely it is changes at the diurnal level, at the whenever the sun, that is at the night also, in the temperature, it goes down. So likewise, some of the pools are there, then water flows from the waterfalls, then comes to a pool area. So these are the sites of Rani Khama, Rani Kopili, and this is the Rani Kopili, and that is the Saluka Dare. So these are the three streams available. And this is the, I am showing, that is the, in this plate, this is the confluence of the Rani Khama stream, which is adjoining the Kulsi River. So this is the river. So these are the muddy bottom where fishes also are available. So as some of the catfishes, they have accessory respiratory organ, they can found in the very shallow bottom of the pond, shallow bottom of the pool, that is tree. So likewise, yeah, thank you for a very attention. Thank you, sir. This is my presentation. So I can conclude that fishes are actually, they represent visible measures of the stream ecosystem structures and functions. And stream fishes actually, they need a kind of attention because of the conservation issues. Because if we are not listing them, then they may, I can say their germplasm must be conserved far from anthropogenic disturbances. So thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Dr. Chaudhary. In fact, I forget to show your this slide first. It was really very good to know that on the way you presented the species of fishes, you know, in this northwest region of the country. Undoubtedly, you mentioned that Assam, a particular folks, you know, speaking on northeastern region, is the 36th biodiversity hotspot of this Himalayan region.
Yes.
Having 422 species of freshwater fishes diversity, in out of which 111 species are,
yes,
there in,
yes,
Assam.
Sir.
It is very good to know. And you selected three streams for this Kamrup districts of this West Khasi Hill. And in that hill, in that area, there are 58 species of fishes belonging to 41 genera, as well as 23 families and 8 orders, and like catfish and the suckerfish. I heard two names earlier also, because there is a friend of mine from Assam who always and all the time is talking about, he's Dr. Amarjit Sekia. He's all the time talking about the fish, fish, fish. And from his mouth, I just came to know about this catfish and this fish which you mentioned, sucker fish, which you mentioned over here. And fishes named hills are also having ornamental value. It is very good to know, ma'am. It's good to know more because ornamental value is also there. And you rightly mentioned the threats which these hordes are facing, and particular the anthropogenic disturbances. Like this sand extraction is there, then boulder mining is there, deforestation is there, and the disturbances created by this monsoon regions in Himalayan zones. And the Rapian zones, which you stress that it should be systematically studied, and just to understand the ecology at very minute level, so that we can understand on the or more species of these freshwater before it is too late. We have to conserve it, and we have to study it, and we have collectively work just to do or save something to save these fish diversity for the future. It's really good to know. It's really good to know because you cited many names of the variety of the fishes, because I'm not a scientific man of scientific, you know, this geological background. I'm a man of sociology background. That's why I cannot decide and record the name of so many fishes which you put before us all. Anyway, thank you very much, Alora. It was really a very, very good presentation. Sadar, we know through your presentation about the many varieties of the fish.
So, thank you, sir.